So you're looking for the best iPhone photography school for beginners? Well, in this video, I'm going to share my review of iPhone Photo Academy course. Coming up! Hey, photo enthusiasts! Zarina here with Digital World Beauty, bringing you the best tips and tools for becoming a better photographer. On this channel, I share tech gear reviews, course recommendations, and how-to tutorials. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And hey, at any point on this video, check out the links in the description below, because I list out everything I mention in the video. Without further ado, let's get started.
Shall we?
We shall.
When I was asked to review the Digital Camera Mastery course, check out the note cards, I also bought its sister course, the iPhone Photo Academy. The thing is that smartphone is that kind of camera that's always there for you, so a lot of people would want to improve their mobile photography skills. Recently, I read a comment on Reddit forum which said the following: I think there is plenty of free content on YouTube and I'm still seeing this as a gimmick. Let me address this first, and by the way, let me know in the comments what do you think. First of all, there are people who like to be spoon-fed, like me, to accelerate their growth. Take my YouTube channel for example. Before I started this channel and before I produced this video, I went through the step-by-step course on how to do it well on YouTube. I don't want to search around the entire internet to find how to do it well. I would rather pay and get good results and save time in the process. Second of all, there is value in this iPhone Photo Academy course. Even professional photographers who mainly shoot with mirrorless or DSLR cameras, they would learn something new. For example, markwithshotkit.com wrote the following on his website. However, the more I watched, the more I realized that this is a course for all standards. Yes, even professionals like myself. It's a little embarrassing to admit this, but I found myself taking notes at multiple times when watching the course. Now I think about it though, even with 10 plus years of pro photography experience under my belt, this doesn't mean I know everything about using a device normally reserved for making phone calls to take a great photo. Composing an image with a phone screen is a lot different to composing one using my DSLR's viewfinder, for example. And then he adds the following: learning to shoot within the limitations of an iPhone sensor, or how to shoot with the most of the technology in the iPhone, is something that's not immediately obvious, even for a pro. I'm not even a professional photographer, but Mark is, and even he admits that this course brings a lot of value. And guess what? You do not need to spend thousands of dollars on expensive gear. Believe it or not, but you can take awesome photos with just your smartphone. And you don't need a fancy new iPhone model to join the course. Nor do you need to have any experience with photography. In fact, the less you know, the better. Emile, the instructor, gives very good explanations even to most complex terms. And his lessons are usually 10 to 15 minutes long, which in my opinion is awesome because you're not gonna get overwhelmed by the amount of information on a particular topic. The lessons may be short, but there are a lot of topics covered in the iPhone Photo Academy course. Generally speaking, you learn about the essentials of an iPhone camera, the principles of great photography, and creative iPhone photography techniques. Not only that, but Emil also covers the principles of photography composition like rule of thirds, exposure lines, shooting from creative angles, and so forth. So what is the structure of iPhone Photo Academy? Well, there are 7 modules as well as additional bonuses that come with the discounted price, link in the description. In the first module, you'll be introduced to the very basics of iPhone cameras and photography. You learn how to hold your camera to make sure there are no shakes, the quick ways you can open the camera up, the secret features to use, setting the correct exposure, and so forth. So even if you've never had any experience with iPhoneography, then this module will help you understand the basics. In the second module, you'll be learning about additional camera features that you would probably never find on your own. For example, how to pick the right camera settings on your iPhone, how to capture action shots using the burst mode, how to take awesome panoramic photos with your iPhone, and how to use the HDR mode. I believe this section is constantly updated because you will see videos that talk about certain features that are available in certain iPhone models. Module 3 is about editing techniques for color and exposure. This is where you learn about simple editing techniques for color and exposure that you will need to know about. And hey, if you're getting value out of this video so far, could you gently tap the like button? Now, module number 4. In module 4, Emil talks about the right mindset as well as principles and secrets to great photography. For example, he talks about how you should choose the perfect angle, how to find the subject to take awesome iPhone photos. He will also talk about how light affects photos, the essential principles of composition, as well as using the creative composition techniques. Now, to experienced photographers, this module might be a little bit boring because they know it all. But as a beginner, you'll definitely benefit from it. Module 5 is about creative iPhone photography techniques. It is where you learn how to tell powerful stories with your photos, how to capture creative reflection photos, how to use shadows to improve your iPhone photos, just to name a few. I believe this is where you get creative juices flowing, and I have no doubts that you will enjoy it. In module 6, you'll be learning about the common iPhone photography scenarios with tips and tricks for every genre. In this section, you'll learn the great tips for taking portraits, the scenery photography, how to take amazing landscape shots, how to crush it with candid street photography, and how to make sure you take sharp photos in low light conditions. Every lesson is 15 minutes long and it's packed with useful information. In module 7, you learn about the technical aspects of iPhone photography, such as balancing ISO and shutter speed. But he also talks about the Camera Plus dedicated app. This app is paid less than $3, but if you decide to invest in it, then you'll have lessons on how to use it. This being said, do I recommend iPhone Photo Academy? Yes, absolutely. So who do I recommend it for? Someone who is a total newbie in photography. Someone who doesn't want to miss a shot with their smartphone. Someone who needs to understand all the tips and tricks of iPhone photography. And if they want to learn from someone with years of experience. If you are that person, then you'll definitely enjoy iPhone Photo Academy. Question of the day. Do you prefer to shoot with your DSLR or iPhone? Let me know in the comments below. Hey, I want you to tap the notification bell because in the next video, I'm going to talk about the frequently asked questions about iPhone Photo Academy. In the meantime, check out the note cards for more videos.